Assalamu alaikum. This is Ms. Shaina Paras from Dalal Akhtar Khan Government College of Home Economics, Karachi. Today I am delivering a lecture on sustainable fashion for PS5 under the subject marketing and merchandising. We love fashion as much as the next person. Fun outfits, glamorous accessories, individuality, what's not to love? With a road ahead, is it easy? It's non-necessary that we all learn what qualifies as truly sustainable and ethical fashion. We hope not only educate you and ourselves on the problematic status of the industry as it currently stands, but also provide you with knowledge necessary to judge whether a clothing company or item is truly ethical. Call it a fashion framework. Sustainable fashion is a movement and process of fostering change to fashion products and the fashion system towards greater ecological integrity and social justice. Sustainable fashion to us predominantly applies to things that are environment related. How are textiles made? Avoid using pesticides by using organic products. Second, what materials are used? Cap versus nylon. Third, what standards are applied? Example, GOTS, Global Organic Textile Standard, Fair Trade, Ecotex Handbook. Four, whether materials are recycled, how textiles are packaged and whether recyclable material is used for packaging. Essentially, sustainable ethical fashion is an approach towards sourcing, manufacturing and designing clothes which maximizes the benefits to the industry and society at large. At the same time, minimizes the impact on environment. Ethical fashion deals with the moral side of industry, namely animal rights, human rights, inclusively supply chain transparency. It asks, who made my clothes? Where are textiles made? How much workers paid to grow crops and to make garments? Are their working conditions acceptable? How are they treated by their employers? Let's go to the next slide, that is covering closing the loop on fashion and textile. This cycle starts with the raw materials, then the manufacturer designs that product, it has been manufactured in the factory, then it has been distributed to retailers and wholesalers, then that product, t-shirt or any garment has been used, then reused or repaired, then if it's not been used by anyone, then it has been collected by the industry, it has been recycled, again it has been made the raw material, and the cycle goes on. Sustainable fashion systems can create value to people, environment and business. How the cycle comes, it covers three things: planet, people, profit. How planet has been covered? Like cleaner production, less impact, less industrial production, less waste. Let's go to people, product safety, product satisfaction. Profit includes new business models, profit with less manufacturing. Let's go to the background of sustainable fashion. Sustainable fashion came from public and later 1980s and early 1990s as well-known companies such as Patagonia and Esprit brought sustainability with their business. In 2011, Patagonia ran an ad and PR campaign, "Don't buy this jacket." This ad encouraged people to buy products when they need. We can see in this slide that mentioned "Don't buy this jacket" slogan by Patagonia that covers four aspects: reduce, repair, reuse and recycle. While other clothing companies try to lure their primarily female customers into buying more and more clothes, the outdoor clothing brand Patagonia tries to convey a completely contradictory message
Their slogan, "Don't buy this jacket," combined with a picture of one of their own products, relates to a new campaign aiming at reducing, repairing, reusing, and recycling.
Next, go to the topic, what's the purpose of sustainable fashion? The fashion industry has a clear opportunity to act differently, pursuing profit and growth, while also creating new value and deeper wealth for society and therefore for world economy. To create following ecosystem and commodities through its activity. It includes increasing value of local production and products, prolonging life cycle of raw materials, increasing value of timeless garments, reducing amount of waste, reducing the harm to our environment created as a result of production and consumption. Let's go to the topic, fast fashion. It's a contemporary term used by fashion retailers for designs that flow from catwalk quickly to capture current fashion trends. It is an inexpensive clothing produced rapidly by mass market retailers in response to latest trends. Let's have a look on next slide. In the first picture that shows how fast fashion is destroying our beloved world by not choosing recycling the garments and it's being done. Let's look at the second picture. Fast fashion is act as a fast food. Like factories are filled with workers, rivers are full with chemical waste, cupboards, wardrobes are filled with clothes, landfill. It's a site for disposal of waste materials filled with the discarded garments. Now it's the time to take action. We should do process matters, quality do matter, honesty at the top. Let's look at the third picture. These are the pictures of the renowned fast fashion brands named Forever, H&M and Zara. Let's look at the next topic, that is slow fashion. Slow fashion is an alternative of fast fashion and same principles to be followed as slow food, like good, having good quality with yummy flavor should be healthy. Let's go on the second point, that the product should be clean enough, it should be free from hazardous chemicals and environment friendly. And the third topic is fair. It should be affordable prices for end users and good pay for producers. We can see the slow fashion movement. Slow fashion movement includes less wastage, reducing carbon footprint, use organic products, improve working and living conditions for people, to use with certified manufacturers like COS, Ecotech, etc. Choose quality, not quantity. Having safe and healthy working environment. Let's shift to slow fashion. Includes ethical fashion, eco fashion, and lasting fashion. Ethical fashion. It's an umbrella term to describe ethical fashion design, production, retail and purchasing. It comes huge range as working conditions, sustainable production, animal welfare, fair trade, etc. Second, eco-fashion. Eco-fashion, it's all about making clothes that take into account the environment, the health of consumers, working condition of people in fashion industry. Eco-fashion clothes are made of organic raw materials such as cotton grows without pesticides and silk made by warm fed on organic trees. The third but the least, lasting fashion, concerns the garment itself and slowing down the clothing consumption rate. Let's compare fashion, fast fashion versus slow fashion. You can see it in these pictures.
fast fashion versus slow fashion, the retail cost of the fast fashion is about $26. If you get compared with the retail price of slow fashion, that is about $21, $5 less. In fast fashion, the fabric used is basically made of yarn or spandex, whereas in slow fashion, the quality of fabric is organic cotton. Why? The shrink and loses shape quickly in fast fashion fabric garments, while in slow fashion it lasts for longer time. No supply chain transparency in fast fashion, while in slow fashion supply chain transparency is there always. For fast fashion, the origin is unknown, while in slow fashion sweatshop free. The slogan is fast fashion is out, while the slow fashion is in nowadays. Let's switch to another topic, that is environmental concerns related to fashion. Environmental impact of fashion. The fashion industry basically is one of the major polluting industries in the entire world. The production and distribution of the crops, fibers and garments used in fashion all contribute to different forms of environmental pollution, including water, air and soil pollution. How can we reduce the fashion environmental impact? We can reduce our fashion environmental impact by buying less garments. Even the greenest garment brands are used, but we should reduce our usage. We can buy clothes from sustainable brands where the quality is good. Think twice while using, how can we reduce a fashion environmental impact? We can reduce the fashion environmental impact by buying less clothes, even the greenest garments, using resources for production and transport to your home, creating some environmental impact too. Second, buy clothes from sustainable brands. Buy better quality. Think twice before throwing out your clothes. Buy second-hand and rented clothes. Keep an eye on your washing. Environmental hazards. Highly consumed resources used by textile industries are fuel, chemical resources, and water. By giving low process efficiency. Nowadays, top buyers like IKEA work only with those manufacturers who have wastewater treatment plants, having eco-friendly environment, using azo-free dyes, and mainly who are Ecotech certified suppliers. Pakistan working on sustainable fashion too. Due to rapid climatic change, it's also a responsibility as consumer to change our purchasing habit and focus on sustainable fashion. Here I can discuss six brands paving the way to make Pakistan green. The brand names are Generation, Sapphire, Levi's, FNK Asia, Misha Lakhani and Inaya. Let's discuss the Generation first. Couple of years, Generation is working on eco-friendly products. They are not only using organic cotton, but also recycling plastic to produce their clothing. With their new recent campaign named Sohni Dharti, keeping in mind many environmental problems like lack of water, air pollution, deforestation, etc. Let's move to second Pakistani brand named Sapphire. Previous years, Sapphire has launched biodegradable seed-infused shopping bags in honor of Independence Day. They encourage people to grow more plants for greener Pakistan. Let's move to Levi's. Levi's has taken steps to use less water by farmers in growing cotton using alternative methods as Pakistan is facing water scarcity problems. On number 4, SNK Asia. Huma
has a joint venture with UNHCR to design jewelry collection called Craft Stories, also giving training to Afghan refugees women by making unique handicraft pieces for FNK Asia. Moving to Misha Lakhani, Miraka brand by Misha produces a garment with extreme detail by using handloom method as handloom weaving. This collection not only promoting Pakistani cultural heritage but also an important step towards women empowerment. At the last, the brand name is called Inaya. Miss Brohi, giving an opportunity to women in rural STEM by having their own team and run their own business. In this way, they can sustain themselves, run their houses too. At the end, I can discuss easy ways you can make your wardrobe more sustainable. Wash your clothes less and avoid the tumble dryer. Your wardrobe should be organized. It should be organized in a way that formal dresses at one end, semi-formal, and the garments that are used daily at home. Try to always buy organic cotton instead of garments used by cotton used by pesticides, grown by pesticides. Never ever throw clothing in the bin. You should give to the needy people instead of throwing it in the bin. Alter pieces you already own. If the garment having button has been torn off, you should repair it instead of throwing it. Thank you.